My research topic is identifying and analyzing the demand and consumption patterns of gold leaves in water sector. Going into introduction, water is the primary necessity for all forms of earth, as we all know. When compared with the overall water distribution of the world, the freshwater accessibility of water is 2% of the overall water stock in the hydrosphere. So, due to this limited water availability, it is important to conserve water for the future. Hence, managing the available fresh water in each country is very much important for the living beings of the world. The problem statement is that the national water supply and drainage board have an idea about the amount of water needed for domestic use. It doesn't have a clear idea about the quantity of water being used in the industrial sector. When it comes to industrial sector, the hospitality industry, hotel sector is an important part. So the hotel sector has a high demand of water. National water supply and drainage board supplies water for 305 tourist hotels in the Karak district, and most of these hotels use almost drinking water for its users. This research was started with the aim to help effectively manage the demand of water of national water supply and drainage board and for the future forecast of industrial water demand. And the objectives are to analyze the patterns of water use by hotels during a year and to establish a relationship between water consumption and influential variables which affect for the water consumption of hotels. This research is based on the hotel sector of Sri Lanka, but due to limited time frame, only the hotels of coastal belt of Kannangara district were considered for the research. The methodology adopted was the data were collected from primary and secondary sources. From primary sources, the primary data collected was to identify the influential factors of water consumption in hotels. And the secondary data were collected to find out the monthly water consumption levels of hotels. From both of these primary and secondary data, find out the relationship between influential variables and average water consumption values using graphs. Then develop an equation to predict monthly water consumption values at hotels at seasonal and off-seasonal periods. From the primary data, this data were collected by making site surveys for the hotels, and data collected were the account number of the water bill of the hotel, the number of rooms, occupancy rate, and the number of employees at the hotel. From this secondary data, data were collected from National Water Supply and Drainage Board. The water consumption values of the last 3 years of National Water Supply and Drainage Board related to each hotel were collected separately. The number of hotels that required to be considered in data collection were identified using sample size calculator from Creative Research System website. In the coastal belt of Kallam district, there are totally 240 hotels. To get an accurate result, the sample size that needed to be considered for the research was taken as 120 by giving a confidence level of 95% and confidence interval of 5. From the survey result, two seasonal variations were identified as from April to November and November to April. The table 1 shows the water data that collected. The account number is the account number related to water bill of each hotel. The number of rooms, employees, and the occupancy rate of each hotel were collected. From the data collected from National Water Supply and Drainage Board, the average monthly water consumption values of each hotel was calculated by taking the average of last 3 years' consumption data. In the table 2, the customer billing summary of a hotel is shown according to the hotel account number, and the consumption meter reading was taken from National Water Supply and Drainage Board data, and the average of each month was calculated taking the last 3 years' data. And to identify the relationship between water consumption and influential variables, graphs were plotted for both season and off-season periods. For the relations of of consumption was number of groups, consumption was number of employees, and consumption of number of people in place. The considerations that made were, for the seasonal period, the occupancy rate is taken as 100%, so number of occupied rooms is equal to the number of rooms of the hotel. For the off-seasonal period, the occupancy rate given by each hotel was considered as the actual value. Hence, the number of occupied rooms is not equal to the number of rooms of a hotel. The number of employees and the number of rooms of a hotel are constant in both seasonal and off-seasonal periods. When graphs were plotted, a linear relationship was observed in every graph, which drawn as consumption versus influential variables. These two figures show the variation for the seasonal period, and these three graphs show the variation in the off-season period. When graphs were plotted, a linear relationship was observed in every graph, which drawn as consumption versus influential variables. So to derive the equation, multiple linear regression was performed using SPSS software. The following equation was considered, where y is the average consumption per month, x1 is the number of groups, x2 is the number of employees, and x3 is the occupancy rate. Two separate equations were considered for both seasonal and off-seasonal periods. For the seasonal variation, the dependent variable is average consumption and the independent variables are number of rooms and number of employees. After analysis, the coefficient table was obtained as in table 3 and the equation was obtained as shown in the right hand side. For the off-season period, dependent variable is average consumption and independent variables are the number of rooms, number of employees and number of occupied rooms. The coefficient table was obtained as in table 2 and the equation is obtained like this. Then the predicted consumption values for both seasonal and off-seasonal periods were calculated from the equations. The predicted values and actual consumption values were compared. And the following data sheet in table 5 shows the values of actual consumption values and predicted values in seasonal and off-seasonal periods. When compared with the values, both the values are approximately equal. Conclusion that both predicted values and actual values are approximately equal. So the derived equations can be used for predicting the consumption values of a hotel if the number of rooms, number of employees and occupancy rate of a hotel is known. And the season period is from November to April and the off-season is from May to October. And the average water consumption values in seasonal period is higher than the number of consumption values in the off-seasonal days. And a national water supply and drainage board can predict consumption values earlier by using these two equations, and it will be helpful to do their design criteria in future. These are the references made. Thank you.
The forum is open for Q&A.
Thank you for your informative presentation. And you have the number of samples, which is currently found by considering 95%. But this 100, how about this type of hotels? Because there are different types of hotels. Some are big hotels, some are small, medium, and some of them have a swimming pools, right? There are different things. Did you consider that? The type of hotel?
No, actually, I
started
from
120
hotels in the
cost of the hotel. Cost of the hotel. You did not consider at least the stars, 3 stars, 4 stars, something like that. Because sometimes, based on this, the facility they have, the swimming pools and other things, might be different. But, yes. And the next thing I'm Now you consider off-season and the season, that the tourist off-season and the season. And you didn't consider about this dry season and the wet season. Even these two seasons, there are some, like rain season and dry season. Sometimes water consumption pattern might be different with that. Maybe it depends because of your time limitation, you might have not considered, but just for your suggestion, if you are thinking about future, the conduct future research ideas on this.
So I have a concern now in validating your equations. You have considered the same hotels that have taken, but have you checked that your equation with the different hotels? Because you said it is only 120, but in the comparison, you said 305 something. So have you checked your equation with the hotels that have not taken connecting data? If that equation is going to be valid?
Equation was validated for the same hotels, but calculating whether that the
how we can say, because that equation is valid for your selected hotels, but how you can say it will be valid for the rest?
Shared and prediction will come match. So simply you can validate the results which way the different hotels stay the same. You can easily
the last 3 years later.